Coming back to the class, so the first thing I wanted to say is mock number two. So mock number two students, if you observe comparatively with mock number one, the positive is the paragraph structuring has improved. But if you see the point of view, thinking as a finance manager still needs to be improved. Anstro, can you hear me? Can we have the moderation, please?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so students coming into this point of view, now, you need to be very careful, students. This time, they have specifically given us technological development. That is very, very important. And students, I have connected the technological sections mostly in the initial stages because I want your mind to be fixed with the technological point of view of thinking. Now, students, if you observe this very carefully, they're asking you first, you are aware about the competition that is rising due to extra frugal business development. Now, before I start explaining this, I want to ask the children of this class, students, can you tell me extra frugal business development? Extra frugal business development. Now, students, can you tell me what does that mean? Extra frugal business development. What does that mean, students? Extra frugal business development. Anyone in the class, you can use the chat box, you can talk as well. What is extra frugal? Because if you had understood the extra frugal properly, you will be able to understand this question properly. So I'm getting some answers as well. Low price, you are saying. That is fine, low price. So I'll write down here low price. Low price, you are saying. But low price is penetration strategy, right? Because be very careful, students. Low price is penetration strategy. If I'm not mistaken, low price is penetration strategy. But this is extra frugal business development. Because be very careful, penetration is different. Giving the product with affordable price, okay. Any other point of view, students, instead of affordable price, something like that, students. Something like that affordable price. More cheaper or economical, okay. More cheaper or economical. You are going with the verb cheaper only mostly. So I'm getting the points. Frugal means cheaper. Okay, cheaper. Affordable prices also you are giving. Affordable prices also you are mentioning. But any other point of view, students, because this is very, very important. This concept is the new concept in the world. Value for money is the correct answer. So extra frugal business model is a value for money business model. Value for money business model. Value for money business model. Thank you very much, Mr. Funny, for giving that answer. So, Ansfro, can we have a small discussion if you do not mind, Ansfro?
Yes, sir, sure.
So, coming into the extra frugal business model, I will guide you how this works out. Now, if you see a company like Samsung, okay, they have high range products as well, if I'm not mistaken. They have products which can be at 70,000 INR, agree, no, Anstro. There are products. But
yes, sir.
The company like Huawei, what they have done is they are giving almost the same product, same quality, no compromising, same usage, but it is only for how much? 30,000 INR. Are you understanding what I'm saying? That means you are giving more value for less price. You understand what I'm saying there? Yes or no?
Yes,
more
sir.
More value for less price. More value for less price. More value for less price. That is the critical idea about this extra frugal model. Extra frugal model. I will come to the point of view. Basically, if you see Levi's jeans now has a lot of competition from Indian manufacturers who produces jeans, and that is extra frugal. What do you think, Anstro? Yes or no? Do you think
yes, sir.
People will come behind you and check whether you have a Levi's tag in your jeans, or will they be bothered about the shininess and the usage of the jeans? Generally, the usage of the jeans. So So students get that point of view properly. So extra frugal is the main concept here. Now I will come to a practical question before going into the point of view of Rinta. Now let's assume, how will companies who are already established, now I'm asking you a question, companies already established will survive this threat? That is my first question to the class. Can someone tell me? No need to go to the Frenta case study. Can you just say how they can generally survive this threat? Any answers, students? Any answers you can give me? So how I'm getting some answers. Start new product with lower range? No, that will affect their positioning, right? It will affect their positioning. Other than that, how you can survive these students? That is my first point of view. How you can survive these things? Investments? No, this is just a basic idea you are saying. I want the practical. Find new markets? No, because of globalization, everyone is finding easily a market. Easily you can reach a market due to the development of information technology. Can I ask a question from the class? Anyone using Apple laptops may be knowing, how does Apple position themselves, if you do not mind? How do they position themselves at the moment? Because they are having a threat of extra frugal businesses affecting them. Don't say iOS. iOS is a different thing. But other than iOS, how they are able to attract their consumer base? Apple users? Find new market? No, not air. The main reason is, I'll give you the answer, how they develop innovation? No. I can generally say high level of security. Now, if you observe any other product compared with Apple, Apple is one of the product which is having higher level of security, that everyone may know that, because it will always ask lots of questions before you are installing a software. So just remember that. That is very, very important. Now, coming to the extra frugal business development, how you can survive is, one is called brand positioning. What is that? Brand positioning. Now, example, I will ask the basic question. Rolls-Royce, will that get affected because of extra frugal products? Can I ask that question from Anstro?
No, sir.
So, Rolex, will that get affected because of these developments? I don't think so.
No, sir.
And in the pre-seen material, what we have realized is printer business is a premium segment. What do you think, Anstro? Yes, sir. It's a premium.
Yes, sir.
Now, my question is, when it's a premium segment, it will have social value. What do you think? Yes, sir. Social value.
Yes, sir.
So social value is one factor that can be always used to preserve the business by using social values. Are you clear with that, Anstro? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, so many watches have come. Extra frugal watch brands are there at a higher level, but still Rolex has maintained themselves at a very strong level because of the social values they have created. Now, can I ask you one question? House is a symbol of social security. What do you think? Yes or no, students?
Yes.
House is a symbol of social security. I will ask the question from Shabnam. Shabnam, can you please tell me, Shabnam, what is social security?
Security from theft. Can be one. Theft of your belongings.
Okay, very good.
Trespassing.
Very good. So social security, I'll write down here. Social respect. What do you think, Anstro? Yes or no? Because have you seen, when you say that you have your own house, the social respect is there. Are you understanding, Anstro?
Yes, sir.
Students, now if you observe this, and another point of view is, house is a need. It's not a want. Correct me if I'm wrong. Yes or no? So just remember that Apple laptops, brand positioning, printer, and the house is a very, very important element at the moment. So one more thing, students, that you need to keep in mind is you are living in a developed nation. So in a developed nation, what can happen is extra frugal can come into the picture. But what about the standard of living? Because standard of living plays a major role. My question to the class. Now, when the standard of living is very high, I think if you look at countries like Dubai, standard of living is very high. So will extra frugal play a major role? Yunus, can you tell me, will extra frugal play a major role in an area like Dubai? I'm just asking from your personal experience when the standard of living is very high. I don't think I'm getting the answer. No, it's a very clear short answer. No, because when the standard of living is very, very high, it may not have a huge impact also as well. So one of the main thing that was missed in the point of view is the market standard of living and the social security. Because students, if you generally say that your house is having a Frinta product, which is a 50 years old established brand, you have high reputation for the house as well, if I'm not mistaken. Just a point of view, students, because I generally say that one of the marketing strategy that many organization follows, especially the university, especially the chartered institute, is a social respect. Now, can I ask you one question, students? Now, if you see CIMA, at the end of the day, when you qualify, you may get the ACMA title, but it does not give you an assurance that you may get a promotion or you may get a job increment. But the ultimate idea is you may definitely get a social respect. So that's the point of view. So students get the point here. So coming to the understanding. So I believe the extra frugal model has been explained properly here. So you would have got the idea. That means value for less money, high value for less money. So coming to the next idea, students, I will just write down. What are the alternate strategies we can have to develop digital operating systems in Frinta? Now, some students are writing digital sales system, marketing system. No, operational system, operating models. So coming into the idea, students, the first thing what I can write down here is I will write down a heading. First thing I will write down the heading, because heading is very important for every question. So alternative strategies that can be used to develop, to develop digital operating system. Alternative strategies that can be used to develop digital operating system. So I will just leave a line because it's 40 marks. So students, can you remember marks allocation wise? 40% means of 25 marks, 40% is how many marks, students? 10 marks, correct? No, students. So 10 marks, you need to have 5 paragraph. That is, I can say the ideal, not the correct one, ideal standard. 5 paragraphs with high level of discussion, Students, don't worry. This Saturday, I will teach you the examiner's marking guide as well, so that you will be more clearer of how to pass the exam. So the next one, students, after that 40%, the other one is also 40%. So moving into the next one, we have clearly observed after the retirement of the founders, we do not have much innovation or disruption in the market. Now, Ansro, I want to ask one question. Is that sentence playing a major role here? Yes or no? Because if yes, our company was started by a plumber, which ended up as the number one consumable product in the household for heating and ventilator controllers. And then in 1990, they ended up as a listed enterprise and the owner left the entire organization, including by disposing his own company shares. My question to the class is, what the owner did for 20 years, did the new management continue for the remaining period? What do you think? Shabnam, what the founder did for 20 years, did the management continue his level of speed for the next 20 years?
they did, and then they finally came up with speakers.
Correct. They did not end up with the innovation. They just went up with the product modification. What do you think? Now, if you see students, Apple is no more innovation. It's just a modification. Innovation is what we experienced when Steve Jobs was alive. But after his death, we are not getting any innovation. We are just getting product modification and product replication of already existing products with some differentiation only. So please, can you develop some disruption model that we can use in the company? So they are asking that as well, disruption model. So please don't worry. I will guide you how we can develop disruption model inside the company as well. The next one, please explain how we can build talent within Franta. Now, my next question is, our R&D is very poor. Did you observe that transfer? Yes or no? Because they have clearly told that we can't develop a product superior to it. Why be burned? Agree or not agree, Anstro? Yes or no?
Agree, sir.
Doesn't even they openly say means, do you think, do you need to pay salary for those people? If they are openly saying they can't do that, that means there needs to be some development in the HR when a can't is coming inside the organization. Makes sense or doesn't make sense?
Makes sense, sir.
Makes sense. So coming to the next one, students. So let's write down here. Disruption models that can be used, by Franta. That can be used by whom, students? Franta. Disruption models that can be used by Franta for your understanding. Disruption model that can be used by Franta. Again, 5 paragraphs just for your idea. And the last one, talent building in Franta. Next one is talent building in Franta. Talent building in Franta. This is the next one, students, for your basic understanding and ideology. So let's write down here, talent building in Franta. So these are the three main point of view for talent building, actually 5 marks. So 2 paragraphs or 3 paragraphs is more than enough. Again, I will do the workings and show. 25 marks multiplied by 20% is effectively how many marks, students? 5 marks. 5 marks divided by 2, effectively it gives you 2.5 paragraphs. So this is the international way where the royal charters, the chartered body, estimates the marks of the students. You get what I'm saying, Astro? Because they don't give marks for a very, very long answer without any heading or any flow. The flow of the answer must be there. So students, now if you observe, I need the flavor of a finance manager. So, Sharmin, can we have a small discussion?
Yes, sir.
Sharmin, your answer this time had lot of flavor of a finance manager of Franta. Very good. Can you say some tips like how you manage to improve your marks? Because from 48, you have gone to 86 this time. Can you please tell me what changeover happened?
I think I tried to write it in a more structured way by bringing in first the business knowledge, then trying to implement, or I won't say implement, trying to bring in the pre-seen knowledge then, and then trying to find a solution on who can actually perform that work.
Super. And how did you align your thinking pattern towards the business? Like, did you reread the pre-seen material once again and make short notes like that and come back? Or what was your secret behind that?
The secret was I initially had a scheme through of the pre-seen. So this time I read it like first to last. And I also looked into your previous videos on SWOT analysis, pre-seen summary and stuff, those things. When I went through them again.
Excellent. Excellent. Thank you. Okay, now coming to the answers now, students. So we have now structured ourselves very clearly. These are the 3 major areas. Now let's go through the Narendra Sengal. Narendra Sengal is from where? He's the R&D. Has met you on a staff meeting and he has got the current statistics of data relating to the revenue and segmental analysis of the heating, ventilator, controller and smart speakers. He has done some basic research and submitted the report to the management. The management has provided the report, so refer the reference material. They are wanting you to address how we can develop some updated digital operating business models to be competent in the market. And also they have also sent another request on improving the skills and talents in the entity. So coming here, what Narendra Singhal is telling, new entrant in the smart speaker industry with extra frugal concept, that is the main idea. Currently at Westland, an Indian company has started selling its local made smart speaker, which has all the features and it's very cheap. It has disrupted the market since consumers want to save money, since the speakers are only a command. For their reason, fingerprint sales has been less compared to the last year. Further, we need to develop some business disruption, or else we will not be able to compete in the market. So we need to evaluate some solutions to improve the current situation. Further, in research and development, most staff join after university just to get the training. Once the training is over, they leave. There is no development in the form of innovation. So we need to develop some solution to overcome this. So we get the clear picture of the current situation. Extra frugal model has come into the main business. So here we need to think a little better on how to compete with the other players. So the first thing, students, what if I was in your situation, I would have just written about business ecosystem, because business ecosystem is a new area in the E2. So when you are writing about business ecosystem, you are relating it to the management. And one more thing, some students are writing the history of the company. No, don't say Ratan Tata, India is a developing country. Currently Tata is in India. Don't say, he already knows. Don't tell him. So it's waste of time. So you need to directly say what we need to do with Air India. That's it. Okay. Business ecosystem. So I will write here for the speaker industry, there are no much, I can say, complexity. That everyone is very clear. No much complexity. And very, very less orchestration. Very less what? Orchestration. Therefore, we need to understand that this business model at the moment is slowly moving into Shark Tank. Moving into what tank? Shark Tank, because students, a Shark Tank is a red ocean strategy. It will be bleeding, because when frugal item comes to the market, can I be very open to you now? If you see the headphones or the headsets what you use, Sharmin has become into a Shark Tank. What do you think, Sharmin? Yes, sir. Because there was a period headphones were very expensive, but now if you see the headphones are having very much competition. You see, unknown brands are also coming in online search. Have you ever observed that, Sharmin?
Yes. The range of price is very, very big.
Correct. So students, now, if you can give this as a basic idea, it will be really, really appreciated in the point of the CIMA examiner as well, because business ecosystem students, you need to look at the recording number 3, where we have discussed the ecosystems as well. Because if you see, we are dominating the heater and the ventilator business. But here, this time, they are specifically asking towards the smart speaker. Because this theme is full of smart speaker, but the previous question was overall. This question is specifically to the smart speaker. So I need to write down here, therefore, a differentiation, or an orchestration means a formal or informal collaboration. Formal or informal collaboration. I will give you a classic example. Students, when the first pandemic came, Zoom, if you see, Zoom platform was openly criticized by most of the large giants, saying that it is not safe. Sharmin, can you remember that? All were saying that Zoom is highly exposed to cyber risk. Can you remember that, Sharmin?
Yes. And also, then, it does not allow more than a certain number of participants.
Correct. And they were telling to use Google Meet or to use, for example, Microsoft Teams. So that clearly shows how the orchestration works out. They collaboratively join and they don't want a third party coming inside, because it will definitely affect their company reputation, and also it may affect the market share also. So that is the classic example of orchestration. So I think one student asked me, can we write practical example? Yes. Now see here, Zoom platform is a real practical example how people join together and how they block it, if I'm not mistaken. So students, coming to the next one, how we can survive this business here is a very challenging. So the first thing, students, to keep in mind, the ecosystem is very important. So we need to have, I can say, collaboration at the moment when these things are happening. So the first thing what I can write down here is, one way to survive is data-powered business. Now, can I ask one question? Now, if you see, Google will be very difficult to make a disruption for Google. One main reason is Google generally has the power of data. What do you think, Anshu? Yes or no? Because if you see, Google's data is very strong. Makes sense, no, Anshu? But if you see a new search engine coming, the data power versus Google will be less. Now, one way we can develop is data power. The main reason is we have data for a period of how many years, students? 50 years. So I'll write down here, data powered business model plays a major role in the business development. Since for any digitalization, the source is data. Therefore, one way we can be strong in the market is making data availability in the smart speaker, that is Printer Friend, more than the others. Now, can I ask one question? Now, students, did you observe OTT platforms are coming? Not only Netflix and Amazon Prime, you are also getting Disney or the OTT platform. You are getting Zee OTT platform. So many OTT platforms are coming. But how Netflix survives in the market is a very clear business strategy. They have the data power, because they are also taking the old movies and also putting inside Netflix. How many of you have observed that? Sharmin, have you observed that? Netflix does not contain new things. It also contains old movies as well.
Yeah, one of the examples is Friends.
Correct. One of the examples is Friends, how they developed it. So here, one thing they have is data-powered business model. So this is one of the critical factors that will affect, that can be managed with the current businesses coming forward. Therefore, this may act as a barrier for the new entrant to replicate. Are you clear with these students? Yes or no? Ansfro, is it clear or not clear?
Clear, sir.
So my challenge here is one main problem. The discussion is very important. Now, can I ask a question from Nishant? Nishant, if you are the finance manager of this enterprise, because your answer had that flavor of that finance manager, I'm asking the question from you. Do we have enough resources at the moment to make our business a data-powered business, current situation-wise? So I will ask the question from Charmin, do we have the current situation to make our business into a data power currently?
No, we don't have an IT department. No, we don't.
However, so this is how students you should connect. However, at the moment, we do not have a strong IT department. We do not have a strong IT department to implement this progression, to implement this idea, and further, we may need a third party at the moment for data digitalization of our company customer segments. So that is one more major point that we can make. Now I will write down one thing, students, just asking a question. The most valuable resource in the world now is data. It's more expensive than oil also. Charmin, I believe you are updated with that knowledge. Data is the most expensive resource in the world. So can I ask one question? Can the competitors buy data?
Yes, they can buy data.
In this situation, from whom they can buy data?
In our current situation?
Yes, in our business ecosystem. I'm getting the answer. No, not Google. Wrong answer.
In our current situation, we do have data, but it is not structured.
We can structure everything, but our data still can be bought by someone else. Very good answer. Dronko, you can buy. But other than Dronko, there is something called the construction businesses. What do you think, Charmin? Can we buy data from the construction businesses? Can we buy data from the wholesalers? Can we buy data from the resellers of, our company, Printa? Do we have any data policy between us until now? I don't think there is no data policy, right? So how does the startup businesses disrupt the big giant is they follow the history where the company is having driven. So based on that, they buy the data, and from that data, they generally analyze it. So get that understanding properly. So I will write down here the data. Can we write down, Charmin, the data?
Sorry, I have one question regarding this data.
I will finish this. Okay. The data can be purchased by the new businesses using the contractors, suppliers, and wholesalers in the distribution network. Since we did not have any direct contact with them on data privacy policy. Are you clear with that, Charmin? Yes or no? Make sense or doesn't make sense?
Yeah,
highly makes sense. And one more point, I'll just continue and finish it off. So I can say this is mainly because we did not have a very connected sales strategy. Because we did not have a connected sales strategy. What happened was we generally developed from the other businesses only. We did not directly reach the customer's hand. So that was the main problem that we are facing. So what happens is Printa Friends, our heater, that is our base. From that base only, our consumers are developed. So what happened, we can generally use that and get the items sorted. Example, students, if you see Dumbro in Sri Lanka, Dumbro Furniture, people who has Dumbro only will buy Dumbro washing machine. or else they will go with another brand. So that's how it works out. So Mr. Tahir, your doubt, please.
When it's come to data, buying data from suppliers and distributors, usually they have data which is comes under Data Protection Act.
No, because if you see the history of this organization, no, because it's a 50-year-old organization. And if you see the transaction processing, they have not given anything related to that. So data protection is something that is new, and this company has not updated that till now. You read the pre-sync material properly.
All right, but you know, in generally, a company cannot.
No, generally, no. I'm not talking generally. I'm talking to the business. Generally, I agree with you, but for our business, no.
Okay.
Generally, you are correct. Generally, you are correct. But here, be very careful. We are finance managers of this enterprise. So in that case, we are not having any evidences that we have any data protection rule. Sharmin, I believe that is very clear. Yes or no, Sharmin?
Yes, it is. Yes, yeah.
So students, be very careful. You are the finance manager of this business. Okay, so be very, very specific to that. So one is we need to have a data-powered business, but even having a data-powered business, we are arguing that it may not be strong in future. It may not be strong in future. So that will be a major issue for us later. So the next thing that we can generally focus is, if the businesses are focusing on I can say, extra frugal, another operating model that we can have is customer-centric operating model. So these are the operating models which are generally provided in the examination kit. So if you see, I'm just reflecting this into the business. Now, if you see customer-centric operating model, now example, what YP Burn has done is very much related to customer-centric. Example, you can trace the, I can say, the notes, everything in using the voice command. Now, my question here, Sharmin, because your answer was very good. Now, if you look at Printa, what we can do is we can become more customer-centric. How we can become more customer-centric is provide more security for them. What do you think, Sharmin?
Yes. Yes or no? Yes.
Example, in case someone else is using your voice command, can be done through mimicry as well. So why can't we have something, a protocol or a verb command for a password? What do you think, Sharmin? Because until now, do we have a password through the verbs or through fingerprints or through retina scan, anything like that in our products or in our YP Burns product until now?
No, we don't have that.
But do you think the extra frugal product will have high level of security? I don't think so. They may have high level of features, but high level of security wise, it's still questionable because their cyber risk is little high. What do you think? So students get the point of view. So when someone else is coming with you for a very, very cheaper price with higher value, you need to say the most important value here is something called the cyber security. So I'll write down here the cyber security point is very much important. It's very much important at the current situation. Since there are tendency where online shopping is done through voice command. Are you understanding what I'm saying there, students? Yes or no? So students, the problem what we face, so I'll write down here at Westland. Now this is the practical at Westland. At Westland, still the emergence for cyber security policies are not high. therefore, if we increase the cybersecurity by having, can you remember one thing that is done? Two-way password. Can you remember? I can't remember the correct name. It is starting with two. A two-way password or something. In WhatsApp, everything it is there. In Google also, it's there. It's two-way password or something, if I'm not mistaken. Once you should give the number, password, and the mobile number, correct? If I'm not mistaken. So I can write down by having. Now increases them by having the security embedded, security embedded to both the heating and ventilators, and also for I can say here the print of rent. So we say here two-factor verification, if I'm not mistaken. So there are two-factor verification, and also we can integrate an SMS alert to the mobile phone. What do you think, Sharmin? Yes or no? Does it make a lot of sense here?
We already have this, isn't it? In real life, but not in printer.
Not in Westland. Did you observe that? Yes, sir.
Yes.
In Westland and YP Burn, we did not have. But in real life, we do generally have. But if we increase this, I think will that give a more value to the product? What do you think, Sharma?
Yes. More security.
How Apple has done it for their customer base. Because if you generally see, the Apple users are generally high level, mainly because they do a lot of transactions online, where they need to have high level of security in order to prevent that. So it is giving a more customer-centric operating model. So I'll write down here, this can prevent the frugal competitors products being less reached because the house is a social security factor. It's also a social security factor. And further, we can have connected alerts to police or any security in case of a threat. Like example, you can tell a code number, it will automatically give the GPS everything. Yes or no? Can we develop something like that, Dr. Sharmin? Yes or no?
Yes, this is possible. Yeah.
This is possible. So, Ansro, are you getting these points? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So, students, again, I'm telling there is nothing called correct answer or wrong answer. Anything that you write is a correct answer, provided you justify that. Okay, now the next digital operating model. So these two are highly discussed. So another digital operating model that we can generally work out is something called Skynet business model. So students, Skynet business model, I will just guide you how this works out. So if you see, Sharmin, Skynet business model is generally used in manufacturing businesses. I'll just give you. So I'll write down here, manufacturing businesses. Generally, allocate resources using Skynet model where the efficiency is high. Are you clear with that, Sharmin? Yes or no? Because yes. What we do is, I will just write down this system matches the demand and supply and develops the product for the market requirement using human resource. I will give you a classic example. Surge pricing. There is a pricing strategy called surge pricing, which is followed by Uber. What happens is, Sharmin, is demand and supply, yes or no. So if you see, sometimes the rates may be very high. That means the demand is very high, the supply is very less. Have you observed that, Sharmin? Yes or no? And
yes.
Sometimes what will happen, the price will be very low. The meaning is the demand is low, the supply is very, very high. So how does Skynet business model do is it identifies the resource allocation. Now, sometimes it's very much useful for restaurant business like KFC, McDonald's, everything. They're also using the Skynet because they need to identify the demand and supply and adjust accordingly. Are you clear with that, Sharmi? Yes or no? Now, the problem what we have is with our heating and ventilators, are we currently observing the demand and supply and manufacturing, or we are going with the trend analysis?
We are going with the trend analysis, right?
The historical factors. But I think the best thing what we can do is we can go ahead with the Skynet business model. The main reason is, as per the Skynet business model, we need to reduce the manufacturing of what? Heating and ventilators. And we need to increase the developments of the smart speakers and the, I can say, other required elements, because that is very, very important. Are you getting this point, students? So if you generally see when these frugal businesses are coming, how we can manage this is this model. Can I ask one question to the class? Now, Sharmin, if you see Apple mobiles, do you think the supply is high or supply is managed?
Supply is managed,
right? They don't go for high level of supply. They are actually going for a managed level. But if I come to a company like Huawei or these Chinese products, extra frugals, are the supply managed or not managed? Not managed. So can I ask one question? How to compete with this frugal model is to put the pressure of supply to the market. You get what I'm saying, Sharmin? That means you can develop a system of limited editions. What do you think, Sharmi? Yes or no?
Yes.
Does limited edition for a premium product plays a major role or doesn't play a major role? Major role.
It does.
One way I can say is if you look at 50 years old business, there may be people who are 50 years now, if you see, or there may be people who may be 60 years or 70 years, the old people. So there may be households, if you see, in these developed countries, most of the citizens who are elderly, they only stay mostly in houses. What do you think, Sharmi? Yes or no? The senior citizens. And if you see the working class, they stay at house, but not so often like the senior citizen. Correct me if I'm wrong, Sharmi.
They live in the apartments, flats, or that's somewhere where there is security.
Everything. So my question to the class is, can we use the Skynet business model, identify the old people and develop a vintage ventilator controller, that means which can be controlled using your hand plus voice command, which is very easy for them in their old age? What do you think, Sharmi? Possible or not possible? Can we develop
customized
or a vintage classic version relaunch? Can we do that as a small summary when we are operatingly competing with these people? Yeah, we can do that. So what I will write down here is, I'll just write down, since the company is well established for 50 years, we can use the classic version some digital developments, with some digital developments where we can have a limited edition version, which may generally be a threat to the I can specifically say the frugal suppliers. Do you agree with that? Yes or no, Sharmin? Are you getting that point? Because yes, you are becoming a threat for them. A classic example I can generally say is the Harley Davidson. Now, if you see Harley Davidson motorbike, and I think you may be aware about a motorbike called Royal Enfield. Now, Royal Enfield, Harley Davidson, still they are very strong in the market, because they are using their limited edition version and they are competing with the other bike player. What do you think, Sharmin? Yes or no?
Yeah.
So students get that point of view very clearly. But the, again, the issue, designing department. So this I can write down here. The designing department needs to be updated with the new software developers where they work together and launch a product for the senior citizens, But one issue with this sentence is it is only covering the senior citizen market. It is not covering the other one. Further, we can also identify the requirements of the market and manufacture as per the requirement. Now, one question to you, Sharmin. If you look at the financial statements, YP Burn is having more revenue compared with us. Did you observe that? Yes, sir.
Yes.
My point of view is, I was just thinking, YP Burn may be an innovative product, but they would have positioned themselves as a cost leadership innovator. What do you think, Sharmin? Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Maybe, right? But
maybe,
our company may be a second, I can say the second mover, but still we have positioned ourselves as a premium product. So still there may be a tendency that we may be producing less, but getting greater margins. Can that be a possibility, Sharmin? Yes, sir.
It is possibility, yeah.
It is possible, right, students? You get the understanding of how the industries may function. Because if you see Alexa is once again, I can say, an innovation. But that innovation is generally, being very frank, it's a cost leadership type of innovation. Because Alexa can be affordable by anyone. What do you think, Sharmin? Yes, sir.
Yes.
But if you see Apple TV, I don't think everyone will be able to afford it. Makes sense or doesn't make sense? I think that makes a lot of sense, right? So I will write here, the branding and positioning strategy can be maintained. And the story of the company history can always be used as a marketing factor. Example, zero defects for the past 50 years. Makes sense, right? If I'm not mistaken, because this is how these high level products survive in the market. Are you clear with that, Sharmin?
Yes, sir.
So students, we have taken a lot of time on discussing these main operating models. So any questions you have, you can ask me. before moving into disruption models that can be used by Printa.
Sir, I have a question, but not specific to this portion that we have discussed.
Okay.
So when I wrote my mock, it is supposed to be within 45 minutes, but I took more time than 45 minutes.
Okay.
So I'm not sure whether I will actually be able to write that in 45 minutes. So how do I improve my quality of writing so that I can finish it within 45 minutes?
To improve the quality of planning. You get what I'm saying, Sharmi? Because some people has that ability, they read slowly, but they plan while they read. You get what I'm saying, Sharmi? Because now example, let's assume we are working at a lawsuit, a company where there is a law case, a criminal law or a legal litigation. We need to read a lot of papers, correct? No, Sharmin? So when we are reading papers, while reading, we should get the comprehension that we need to get that points clearly. You get what I'm saying, Sharmin? Because if you're going little more, the problem of the source is the reading. So I think when you have read it very firmly, you could have managed the time. Because typing is an operational factor. Anyone can improve typing by practice. But thinking is not an operational factor. Thinking is an intellectual factor. Because thinking depends always on the situation. Correct? But typing will remain the same. Whatever said and done, you need to type the same manner. So one thing what we can do, learning curve effect, we can apply the theory. Now we are doing the second mock only, but week after next, the dose will increase. That means we may increase the numbers of questions inside the mock. So based on that, you will be able to improve the way of doing. But being very practical, Sharmin, in the exam day, anyway, everyone has that natural fear, like the normal loss we have. You get what I'm saying? So still, in that day, whatever happens, you should play the role of a finance manager than a student. Because if I go to a CIMA exam, my point of view will not be passing or failing the exam. My point of view will be providing solutions which are feasible to the company. That's the way I think. Example, Sharmin, now let's assume a student calls me for a class. It's like a case study example. Why? Because that 2 minutes conversation can turn out to be a sales or can turn out to be a not a sales. Agree, no, Sharmin? So I can't make the same decision every time. You get what I'm saying here, Sharmin? Because if I'm doing the case study, I will observe this is as a client and I'm giving them the solution. And the current way we give the solution is quick solutions with high level of efficiency. Clear? So don't worry. First two mocks completely understand. But later, when you get into the industry, you will find it better. Is that fine, Sharmin?
Yeah, thank you, sir.
And one more thing, students, after you get used to the writing skills, I will make the system into automation where the time will be 45 minutes only. So during that time, you will get the implementation process a little better. So disruption models that can be used by Printa. Now, I'm getting a lot of answers from the students. What are the disruption models they can use in order? So I got some correct answer as well. So one disruption model they can use is partnership with other electric suppliers. Partnership with what? Other electric suppliers. Are you getting that point? Yes or no? Now, when we form a collaboration with other electric suppliers, can that become a huge disruption to the newcomers? What do you think? Yes or no?
Yes, possible if you're partnering with a big company.
If you're partnering with essential companies, what do you think?
Yes.
Like Bronco, after that I can say some other major companies where your product is highly, I can say, secured and faster in processing with this. So that is the major idea, partnering with other electric suppliers. So the best thing we have observed is, students, if you see nowadays, Microsoft, Intel processors, their main success, they are not leaving another processor to come forward. Have you observed that, Sharmi? Because if you see Intel Inside is the name that you would have heard for the past 20 years. What do you think, Sharmi?
Yes,
Yes. Now only we have Snapdragon, everything coming from China. But long, long time ago, Intel was dominating the market because they have partnership with all the laptop manufacturers. Make sense or doesn't make sense? Yes or no?
Yes, it does.
It does make sense. And the second thing what we can do is only without the heating and ventilator controllers, why can't we partner with all other electric appliances? I will give you a basic idea of how that works out so that it will be very clear for you. So students, one more point that we missed out on that day, I will just show it to you students so that you will be very easy, but it's a very good way of disrupting partnership. Partnership is a wonderful way of disrupting the market, because when the partnerships are very strong, what will happen at the end of the day, the consumer needs to end up as the price payer and the market will become the price maker market. So get that point of view properly, students, firstly. So just a minute, students, I will just take the pre-seen material and I will show you one important point that was not discussed on that day for your understanding. So Sharmin, just let me know if the pre-seen material is visible.
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, coming to this point, Frinta's experience in the manufacture of heating and ventilator controllers has frequently involved working with manufacturers of central heating boilers, air condition radiators, so that the Frinta's controllers can be integrated into efficient in both the reliable and easy way to operate. So students, just understand one thing, I will give you a basic idea for students who want to get the clear picture of this. Now, Yusuf, can we have a discussion if you don't mind, Yusuf?
Hello, yes, sir.
Yes, Yusuf, if you have a tube light in your house, mm-hmm. can you fit a Kevilton switch for that tube light?
Kevilton?
Yes. Can you put a Clipsol switch for that light? Yes or no? To control switching on and switching off. Possible, right? That switch.
Yeah.
And can you put a switch, example like orange, to control any light, Philips light or anything? Can you put that? Yes or no? So if you see this ventilator controller is similar to a switch. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah,
and the heater, so AC, is a different supplier. So switch is a different, and the main product is a different. So their main success is their product is very connected with the main boilers, main air conditions, and radiators. Are you getting that point?
Yes. Yeah.
Another example I can give you is if you have a laptop, okay, you can have a Bluetooth mouse. So HP laptop, can you have another brand Bluetooth mouse connected? Possible?
Yes, of course. Yeah, it's possible.
Right? Yeah. So that is the heating controller system. So their main success is they are already partnered with the main capital asset providers. Are you clear with that, Yusuf? Yes, sir.
Yes, I understand.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Okay.
So, Sharmin, coming to the explanation. So, one of their major success in here is they have come at the end of the day that they are very strongly connected with all this. Yes or no, Sharmin? Makes sense or doesn't make
yes.
sense?
Yes, it makes sense.
Partnership with electric suppliers now will come to play. So, I'll write down here. Printer originally was successful because of having connectivity with heaters and boilers and air condition for temperature control. For what? Temperature control. Now, can I ask one more thing from Sharmin? So, Sharmin, can we target only premium branded products in our portfolio? Do you think that will preserve our market? Example, if you see Bronco, maybe a premium branded switch. What do you think, Sharmin? So, can we target higher end and can we maintain our brand visibility?
In the short run, yes, maybe, but in the long run, we cannot because we have all these frugal competitors coming in the market.
Correct.
So we need
but
to have.
Question to you is our customer base, are they middle class or premium customers?
Oh, they are premium customers.
So, premium customers, will they go for a premium brand or will they also go for frugal? That is my social status question.
They'll go for the premium brands.
They will go for the premium brands, right? So the best way I can say, so I'll write down here, the best way we can collaborate with all the premium brands of electric items, all the premium brands of electric items, and create an ecosystem which will be very difficult to replicate. Very difficult to replicate. What do you think? Yes, on. Very difficult to replicate. Because example, if you see Sharmin, Apple products are doing the same thing, right? Because their ecosystem they have created, only these certain items can be there. So this can preserve the existing positioning of the company. Are you clear with that, Sharmin? Makes sense or not makes sense? Because yeah. Sharmin, why did we start manufacturing this? Our main objective of manufacturing smart speakers, it was clearly mentioned, we started producing smart speakers, it should be an effective means of operating. And the other one is, it was clearly mentioned to manage the current market. Correct? No, if I'm not mistaken. Yes or no? So our main objectives was just to preserve our existing positioning. So we can develop a long-term connectivity. Is that fine?
Yes.
Thank you. So what I will do is I will just write down, this may have a premium category of brand affiliation. That means ownership, like BMW, Benz, that's how no they okay. So the next one students, after going to that, is after partnering with other electronic suppliers, the other business model that we can go is incubation. Students, anyone aware about incubation? Sharmin, incubation?
Incubation is where you try to produce something new.
No. Incubation is wrong. So I will write down here. At present, we can incubate some tech startup. You get what I'm saying? Tech startup. And generally, be a venture capitalist investor. Are you understanding that? Because we have a lot of money, so we can become a venture capitalist investor and have a terms and condition, that we will generally take the patents for any new developments, So I'll write down here example. We can fund university research. Are you getting that point? Yes or no? We can fund university research. And we can develop more innovative products rather than depending on the old research and development, depending on old research and development. That is one more disruption model, incubation. Because if you generally see Facebook, they generally spend a lot of money on incubation, where they invest on projects. And the other one is buy another enterprise. So can I ask one question? Can we merge with Y people just to prevent extra frugal coming to the market? Can we do that? Possible or not possible? So I can write down here, possible, right? So YP burn, and I can write down here YP burn and Printa friend, YP burn and Printa friend can come to a joint arrangement, joint arrangement where they can form an alliance. And control the market from extra frugal businesses. The basic example is Boeing's and Airbus. Now if you see Boeing and Airbus, what happened? They merged together. Only they two can manufacture, and they are not leaving a third party aeroplane coming to the business. So Boeing and Airbus example. Therefore, this may end up providing more benefits to both the parties, and they can increase the industry lifespan. Are you clear with that, Sharmin? Yes or no?
Yes.
Thank you. So just another point of view, students. So these are the disruptive models that generally we have. And the other point what I can specifically say is this may not work out. Other one is invest in a tech business. Now we are a listed company, so our shares are valid or not valid? Highly valid, right? What do you think, Sharmin? Yes or no? Everyone will accept, yes, our shares. So I'll write down here, since the company shares are highly, I can say liquid, because you can sell highly liquid due to flotation. We can also invest on tech businesses and collaborate and create disruptions in the market. Example of a clear idea of how the tech businesses were invested and developed was Google invested in YouTube, correct? No. So it's again an incubation. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So that is one way, invest in a tech startup. So that is one point of view of creating the business disruption. So students, just understanding wise, these are the disruption models, how big enterprises do. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Now, if you see a big company like Apple, they can't start from zero and go up because now they are very established. So they will buy other companies and only they will grow. They will buy the companies which are going to grow and they will move forward. Example, a classic example I can generally say is Dialog GSM in Sri Lanka was acquired by Malaysian Telecommunication. So Malaysian Telecommunication, what they did, they created a huge disruption in Sri Lanka, basically by investing in Dialog GSM, and they got the power. I think you may be aware, in Bangladesh, there is Axiata Mobiles, Sharmin?
Yes.
So it is also owned by Malaysian Telecommunication. So that's the point of view. So students, coming to the final one, that is the last one, is how we build talent within Printa. So there are.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, please.
Related to the previous one. So when you mentioned the last point of investing in a tech business, this will have an impact on our EPS, isn't it?
I cannot say because it always depends on the market reaction. Technically, yes, there will be an impact on the EPS, but based on the market reaction, we need to say efficient market hypothesis, how the market accepts. You get the point there, sir.
Okay.
So coming to the next one, students, thirdly, how we can build talent within Printa. So just a small paragraph, sorry for taking time. So how we can develop talent within Printa is one major thing that is missing, students. Inspirational leadership. What is that? Inspirational leadership. Can I ask you one question? Can you tell me Printa organization culture? What is Printa organization culture at the moment? People culture, task culture, role culture, what culture they are following? Why there is no development is culture. So can I say they are following the bureaucratic culture? How many of you will observe that we are following bureaucratic culture? Sharmin, do you agree with me we are following bureaucratic culture?
Yes.
Because most of the business process is standardized. Most of the business process is standardized. So when most of the business process is standardized, students, inside Printa, it is bureaucratic culture. You need to always ask a question, why startups are innovative? Because of culture. You get what I'm saying, Sharmi? Because if you see the startup business, the culture is very much, I can say people culture. They give priority to the people. Agree, no, if I'm not mistaken, they talk to people, they speak to them, they encourage them, they motivate them. But when it comes to a bigger organization, it ends up with bureaucratic culture. Example, when Steve Jobs was there, it was inspirational leadership. When Tim Cook came, it became into bureaucratic leadership. Are you understanding the difference? Yes or no?
Yes.
So the company should be able to shift the culture to more collaboration than manufacturing. More collaboration than manufacturing. Students, get that point of view. More collaborations than manufacturing for your understanding, because the inspirational leadership plays a major role in talent building. If the leaders are not at all inspiring, there will not be a success event. Therefore, the company can develop internal competitions with cash, competitions with cash rewards for your understanding. So students, one major point of your answer that was missing was the inspirational leadership. That was the main issue here. And the other one is, I can write down here, collaboration of all the stakeholders. Now, can you remember there is something called total quality management, TQM. So we take all the stakeholders' comments and develop. So one main thing is building talent is all the collaboration of the staff or everything. So I can write down a plumber can develop idea. A plumber can develop idea. Can develop idea means it should come from bottom. It should come from what? It should come from bottom. It should come from bottom. Now I'm asking you, do we have bottom-up approach? Do we have bottom-up approach after listing? Bottom-up approach is there or not there, Sharmin? What do you think?
We don't have bottom-up. It is
we don't have bottom-up. And currently we are using outside in strategy. We are using what strategy? Outside in strategy rather than inside out strategy. So these are the things of balancing talent. So you can just modify this little more, but I just want to make your thought process very clear. So students, now I will go to the question and answer session, but today it was more into thinking. So let's go to one-to-one. Amar, any questions for the day? Ansro, any questions?
No, sir.
Ashraf, any questions? Tarmin, any questions?
No, sir.
Tahir, any questions? Ivo, any questions? Mirirai, any questions? Mohammed Rahman, any questions? Mustaq, any questions? Ravikumar, Shariar, Sayyid, Vishnu, Yusuf. Thank you. Thank you, students. Thank you. Thank you for your time. So I will give you the next mock today. You can do it and send it to me by tomorrow evening. Thank you very much, students. Have a wonderful day. Take care.
Thank you, sir.